think one room is enough to hold CanJam 2015? Think again. Here's another room.
We have two headphones that are with us on this show. The first is our Ether, which is the headphone here with our signature red ring on it. That's our open back version of our headphone. And then this is Ether C, which is our new closed variant of it. And they both use our proprietary driver that we've been developing for the last couple of years. This one provides a high degree of isolation, but unlike most closed headphones, it doesn't do it with a big weight penalty and without a major degradation in sound quality. This is really nice for shows, and it also is really nice for travel, or because the isolation is so good, reading in bed next to a partner or using in the office in a bullpen. The reason I got into closed headphones to begin with, and most of our models were actually closed, all of our models were actually closed until we did the first Ether, was I used to share a home office with my wife. And one day I got a tap on the shoulder and she said, if you wish to stay married, it's probably a good idea for me to never ever hear the talking heads again.
The name came about by the owner of the company, when building his product, would go home in the evening and said, saying to his wife that he's going to go and play with his SCHIIT. And then when they came to name the company, well, the rest is history, as they say. Here today, we have the new, very newly launched Milnor Tour 2 and the Gunier Multibit DAC. These are both balanced DAC, balanced headphone amplifier and DAC, so they come in the same sort of size as normal products. This also has SCHIIT's solid state tubes called List, which are basically, if you want, this product's multifunctional in a way, in the fact that if you want, you've got tube inputs normally, so you've got the tube sound for the input stage, but if you want it a fully integrated amplifier, or ICs, you just put the solid state tubes in and you've got a solid state amplifier. Similar to what the Lear is, but a bigger version made balanced.
Yes, we have something that is really brand new. We have just started the mass production of it. It's a HD630 VB. We call it VB for variable bass. We found out that there is a new generation that have different approach to music, how to use headphones. They use them on the go, so this is collapsible. They can put that in their bag, in their backpack, and the variable bass give them a chance when the tube, for example, is too noisy in the low frequency range, you can crank up the bass and cover that noise, and that sounds good again. I traveled with that to this place in the airplane, and yeah, it sounds very good. I tried it in the jet and a little bit more bass. Now I can hear the jet noise, now a little bit more, gone. So that's how it should work, and it really works like that.
All of our headphone range follows the principle of a planar magnetic driver. So they all incorporate a planar magnetic driver. We have four seats here, and as you can see, the four seats have been occupied pretty much the whole of the time. So as busy as we can comfortably deal with. The PM3s, the portable ones, use a smaller driver. Whilst I have these in my hand, I can probably show you something that's a reasonably recent addition. You've seen colours before. However, what I have here and here are the latest iteration of the colours. What we now have is red and blue with a grey band underneath, and that's the final version of those.
We have this show, the first time we show it to the world is the first in-ear headphones in 4 years' time is the CN. We spent three and a half years to develop, finish development in this. And from 9 a.m. to 3 p.m. now, everyone tried our headphones. They think they should buy it. And the second headphones we are showing today is the wireless. And this is also the first wireless headphones from V-MODA. It's still keeping the sound signature of our award-winning 21 Editor's Choice M100 with a wireless mode. So it got best wireless sound and the wired sound. So one price for both. So best of two worlds. we spend a long time in development because we want to make it looks nice, and reliability is highest level in the world, and of course the best sound and the best user experience. Even the three buttons here, we almost use half a year to select the buttons and the switches to make it best clicking sound and without hurting your ears. When the click sound is so high right next to your ears, it will hurt. And if the sound is too soft, you can't feel anything. We spend so long time in developing this kind of detail. So I hope our users will like it.
We are making a custom fit so we can make any earphone that you've got, whether it's expensive IEMs or it's entry-level earphones, comfortable, fit, and by the nature of using a soft silicon fit, you've then created the sounds improved, noise isolation's improved, and sound leakage is decreased. We've chucked away the standard small, medium, and large bud and created a tip that fits on the end of it, which happens to be my right ear, and we've created that by creating an image of your ear on a 3D printer, deliver it back to you a few days later, and have something that fits so well that when you put it in your ear, you can shake it around and the earphone won't come out, and it improves the sound quality. And we either do that with what we call a half shell, or we can do it with what we call a full shell. And this is more suitable for larger drivers, and that holds the driver better, gives you a bit more like that pro look as well. We create a full 3D image of both your left and right ears, and we can upload that straight away to the operator and to the printer. It's also far less invasive. It's not a medical procedure. And the whole point being is that we're looking at trying to roll this out into the consumer market. So we're trying to give the benefits of custom fit to everybody. So whatever the earphone, the thought that your earphones did not fit or are uncomfortable should hopefully be a thing of the past.
Very good so far. We've had plenty of people by the stand. It's been extremely busy all day. People really excited about the POR 5000, which is our brand new portable DAP. Very small, very lightweight. Storage up to 2 terabytes via micro SD, which is really useful. Most importantly, it sounds great. People also stopping by for the POR Gold, which is this one, the slightly bigger, chunkier, bigger brother, which also, again, incredible sounding unit. Most people have been really excited about the fact they've actually got buttons rather than touchscreen. Super fast OS on there. People are managing to kind of fly around the system, finding tracks, changing the EQ settings, really digging in deep without requiring any instruction. Very positive reaction so far.
Here at the show today, we've got two new models. We've got the Sonorous 8 and the Sonorous 10. Now these have taken 2 years to develop the driver for this headphone. Basically sort of evolving on from the Pandora series, which was released about 2 years ago. It's going from a dual driver design to a single driver design, and there's a completely new design. So on the top of the range model, there's the speaker is mounted onto an aluminium plate for stability. And in the center of the speaker, there's a titanium dome for the high frequencies. So in the middle of the range model, the 8, there's actually mounted on an ABS mounting frame. But it gives it a very different character to the sound.
So that's CanJam 2015. A rip-roaring success, I think you'll find, as everyone else here has done. And we'll see you very soon for more headphone-related shenanigans.
Older, and she said, if you wish to stay married, it's probably a good idea for me to never ever hear the talking heads again. And so at that point I decided I needed a closed headphone, but I didn't really like that much of what I was finding on the market, so I chose to start modifying headphones, and that's how we started.
See, the moral: open relationships don't work. All right, so here's SCHIIT capitalizing on the way they sound a little bit rude.
I'm here with Summer at... let's try that again. Sorry, I was trying to think of the name of the thing.
I think I'm the nervous one.
All right, that's my way of putting you at ease. Realise that. Hello. Yes, I'm here with Pendulumic, or Pendulumic. You could swing both ways, I suppose. My old mate Hugo. Striking the right chord. Alan Partridge. There you go. And I'm just discovering how difficult this job is today.
Thank you very much, guys.
Little outro. All right, thanks very much. Thanks.
Yeah.
Hey, I'm here with Mark. He's the representative of a certain American amplifier brand. And just how is that pronounced, Mark?
As it looks, shit.
Okay, and could you pronounce it a little bit better for me?
Not really, I think that says it all.
Okay. Nice to see the TT here in London, because I always thought it was on the Isle of Man only, but a little motorcycling joke for you there.
It's an awful joke.
That's how I like them. All right, thanks very much.
Thanks very much.